In this video, we're going to take a look at working with animations. What I'd like to do is set up an animation that creates a glow when I hit the temperature up and temperature down buttons. And I've already added an animation here to this plus button. So on temp up, you know, I've got this little red glow that happens behind the button. And we're going to do the same thing for the minus button. Right now, it is using a up-down naming convention that creates a little glow on the outside when you hit it, but I'd also like to include an animation when I hit that button. So let's take a look at how we set that up. Here, I've got the minus button, and on top, we have that image that we see, and then the image below, we don't see. It's called -_glow. And the reason we don't see it is when I imported it from Photoshop, the transparency was set to 0. And so when it comes in, the alpha channel is at 0. If I turn it up all the way, then we see that we've got that sort of blue glow that exists around it. And what I'd like to do is hide this behind the minus button, which is currently what's happening over here with that red glow. So with the blue glow, I'll take minus glow, and instead of having the image be the full sort of size of this control, which is 180 pixels wide, what I'm going to do is I'm going to scale it, and I'm going to say, don't match the control width. Instead, we're going to divide this by 2, make it half its size, so that's 90 pixels wide. And then here, I'll do the same thing. I'll change this to be 90 pixels high. Now you can see that blue glow is hanging out at the top left of this control, and that's because of the alignment. So it's in the center and middle, then it's behind that minus button. But when it's in the top left, you know, we see it in that top corner. So now we're ready to kind of create that animation that makes it sort of grow out and fade out all at once. So up here, at the top, I've got this green icon to toggle recording animation. So when I click that, you see we've got this red key line that sort of appears around our application view. And this is just to let you know that we're recording an animation. And what that means is that any change that you make in the UI is going to get recorded as an animation step. So what I can do is I can start making all the changes that I want to have happen in the animation. I'll take that minus glow, and we're going to take that width, and if I multiply it by 2, you know, it grows out to 180 pixels wide, and I want to do the same thing with the height. So it grows out in size completely, and then I also want to take that alpha, and I want to go from full visibility down to nothing. So now you don't see it anymore. And those are three steps that just got recorded into the animation. Now at this point, what I want to do is put everything back to where it was, because, you know, you might run this animation several times. So to the right of that recording animation icon is the animation snapshot icon. And when I click that, we're going to move into a new frame. You can see down here where it says recording frame 1. When I click this, it says recording frame 2. And basically, this is a way to work with sequences within your animation. So we had the first stuff that we wanted to have happen recorded. Now I'm in frame 2, and I will take the glow on that blue glow, and I want to put it back to being fully visible, and I also want to hide it back behind that control. So this can go back to 90 pixels wide and 90 pixels high, and that's where I want it to be when the animation is done, so that it's ready to run the next time we run that animation. So now I'm going to toggle recording the animation off, and I'm given this dialog here, so I can name my animation. I'll call it temp underscore down 60 frames per second, and hit OK. And now we're taken into the animation timeline view. So these are six animation steps that make up that animation. Here, this is the steps that have everything to do with the alpha there. And then this one in the middle controls the height, and the one at the bottom is controlling the width of that glow. So These are the values where it goes from fully visible alpha 255 down to zero. And then for here, the height goes from 90 to 180 and so on. And you have those numbers kind of in these bars in the animation timeline view. And you can, you know, click around in here to sort of grow it in size. And also these same steps, you know, you can see everything in the properties view. So what I'd like to show you now are these icons along the top of the animation timeline view. Yeah, you can work with your animation here. The one on the right here, though, if I hover over, it says preview animation. And if I click that, I'm taken into a little window that kind of demonstrates what that animation is going to look like. Now, it's not exactly how I want it to run. If I go back to the beginning, you can see it sort of grows out in size and it starts fading. And then the second half of the animation, you can see that it's shrinking and it fades back in. So instead, what I would like is for us to not see that second half. And I can do that by changing the duration here of this step. And say, and when you're done, in 0 milliseconds, go back to being fully visible. And I'll do the same thing with these steps that take it back to 90 pixels in width and height. So for those step durations, it's going to take 0 milliseconds. And now I've got this animation. If we preview it again, here it starts growing out in size, as we expect, and fades out. And I find that it's fading out a little too early, so what I'd like to do is maybe is shorten this a little bit. And you can grab these little bars and kind of drag their width in the timeline, and it'll change how long it lasts. So for these, I'm going to delay it to start at 150 milliseconds. And I want to finish at the same time as the other steps, which were half a second long, 500 milliseconds. And if I subtract that 150 milliseconds, you know, we've got 350. And now everything's kind of lined up. So also with these, the growing and the width and the height, I'm going to work with the easing rate here. And instead, from linear, I'm going to have it ease out. So it kind of starts out quickly and then sort of finishes slowly. And if I preview that again, that's what we've got as our animation. So now all I have to do is add an action on this minus control to run that animation. So I right click, say add action, and say, okay, on press, run an animation. And then here I can select, you know, temp down. And we already have an animation for temp up. When I hit finish, now you can see that action's been added to this minus control. So here, I'll hit simulate to simulate the project. I'll be asked to save my changes, which I will do. And now we're in our app. When I hit the minus key, we run that animation. Now when I hit the plus key, you can see it's running the temperature up animation. Now they're a little different from one another, and I think I prefer the one that we just did, and that's because they're using different timing and animation rates. So here, if I go back in the animation timeline view and select temp up, you can see that the width and the height, those use that linear rate. So I'm going to switch those to be ease out as well. And for the alpha, we will change that around to start at 150 milliseconds and have that be 350 milliseconds. So if I simulate and save, and now if I run my minus animation or temp down animation and temp up animation, that's looking the ways that I'd like them to do. So that is getting started with working with animations in Storyboard.